dance on the weekend. I came here for the music. He said, she said, I don't believe it. Control, I can delete them. Control, I can delete them.
I'm gonna try to make this video. I've been sitting here for like 10 minutes waiting for my computer fan to turn off, and it's not turned off, so I can't keep sitting here. The amount of time that I actually have to like sit down without my daughter destroying the house is precious seconds. When I went to go check her earlier, you know what she did? She pulled up a chair, like from like a bar stool. She took all of the pillows off of my sofa. She put them all on the chair, got up into like the cupboard so that she could get her vitamins. There's like probiotics in there. Do you know what's gonna happen if she eats too many of those?
Worst diarrhea ever.
Ooh. She's kind of like a terror, I'm not gonna lie. But I said I wasn't gonna call her that anymore. So she is my passion child. She's very creative, she's very intelligent, and she's very, very independent. She's me. There was many, many years that my mother wished on me, one day you just wait, because you're gonna have a daughter just like you, and then you're gonna see what I mean. And I'm sure that she said to me one time, although she will not admit it, you just wait, she's gonna be worse than you. She is. So we all know why I'm here today, right? 1 year, 10 months into the publishing process, 6 years into writing, it's finally here. I'm so scared. I'm not gonna lie. I'm like so scared. I'm so, so scared. It's also circulating around my hometown, and my mother's friends are already trying to figure out who the fish is. It's not that hard. I thought actually I was like really secretive about it until I realized that I totally gave away his parents. I'm sure that there's nobody else who has a kid that age with that description. So I think it's like dead obvious. I'm gonna die of embarrassment. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna die. This is not your typical book, can I just say, okay? It's a very, very, very easy read. Addiction's hard enough. Your life is busy, it's chaotic. So this is a small book. As you can see, it's small. There are very short chapters, like one chapter, you could read it literally actually on the toilet without being weird. Okay, look, here's a chapter. Mer, mer. That's it. You see that? It's like two pages. There's no excuse to like not be able to read it because you don't read, because my husband doesn't read, and even he was able to read the book. It should go down like butter, you know? What was that thing? Oh no, I better not say that. My dad used to say, you just like, no, never mind. I'm not telling you. I'm not going to say it. It's funny, but it's bad. If you want to get a copy of the book, there's a couple ways. So for a signed book, you can get one on my website. I'm going to put the on the screen there for you. You're not in Canada or the USA and you want a book, send me an email and I will happily get one to you. I am doing a map of all of the places that my book is going, and I really, really want to hit at least every continent. So if you're in Africa or Asia or somewhere else in Europe or South America or an island, I would love to send a book to you. I don't really care about the shipping. You can pay me American shipping and I will cover the rest out of my pocket. How about that? Because I think it's just super cool to see it go like around the world. One day I would really like to get it translated. That would be my dream. First in French, second in Spanish, other languages to follow. French, because Canada is a bilingual country, or at least it's supposed to be. It could be a lot more bilingual. I'm one of those people who advocates for the French to be more immersed into our culture. I don't think that we should have to have a translation on when we are listening to the Parliament, for example, speak in both English and French. I would like to be able to use both fluently. That's just me. I know that's not popular opinion though. Is it really bad if I say that I kind of wish that the French had won? I do a little bit. Our culture would be so different. We would have like baguettes and really good food and wine, and maybe we would even have euros, as there is a little tiny, tiny, tiny area of Canada that is still a French territory called Saint-Pierre and Miquelon. Basically, it's a tiny little itty-bitty France over here in North America. And I look at it and I think, gee, that's what it could have been like. Baguettes aside, if you would like to get a book on Amazon, that is also helpful for me. If you didn't see it, the book hit number one for new releases in drug dependency already. I didn't even email my email list about it, and it had already hit number one. I honestly, like, don't know how that happened. it has to be a God thing because I literally didn't do anything. I posted it on social media and that's basically it. Sorry that I'm like washed out like a ghost, by the way. The lighting in here is like real bad. It doesn't matter what I do. Well, that's worse. Okay, anyway, the sunshine is coming back. I am so ready for summer, and probably winter will come and rear its ugly head again, just so that I am reminded that we are still in February in Canada.
Go.
Plus, last year, I planted all kinds of spring flowers for the first time ever. Poppies and tulips and daffodils and, oh, and crocuses. I ordered them from France off of Etsy. Did you know that you could do that? It's pretty super awesome. So excited to see what they look like this spring. But the squirrels got into them last fall, and so I'm not sure if there are many left. So we'll see what happens. But I had a whole color plan, and it was gonna be beautiful. You know how I got those squirrels to go away? I cut my husband's hair and I sprinkled it all over the garden.
Squirrels don't like me.
It works. It really does. It also keeps skunks away, which is also a good thing because nobody wants to smell like a skunk. What does this have to do with the book? Amazon. If you ordered a book, please leave me a review on Amazon. That would be amazing. I so appreciate it. The book is also available online on Barnes & Noble and Indigo. Barnes & Noble and Indigo. Okay, sorry. All right, I'm sorry. I'm gonna stop now. It's available on Barnes & Noble and Indigo. I'm gonna cry. And it's also on christianbook.com if you live in the States, and Walmart. If you would like to carry the book in your store or shop, that would be so awesome. And you can contact me and I will get you in contact with my publisher, or you can contact my publisher directly. They're called Word Alive Press. And I'm sure they're gonna figure out how to do that because I literally have no idea. You could also ask your local library if they want to carry it, or go to your church or to a local rehab. They usually have libraries as well. And that would be so great to have it in there, or to have it as an option for them to have for the wives when their husbands sign up for rehab. Not to go on you, husbands, or anything, but it's usually you. Statistically, it's usually you that's going to rehab. So, you know, I had a kind of fun idea. I was talking to somebody recently, and she was talking about how she knew somebody who she thought needed to read the book, but she didn't want it to be like offensive or like hurt their feelings or whatever. So we were kind of like chatting about it, and she had said, like, as a joke, well, hey, I thought, you know, maybe I would bring her a casserole when I bring her the book. And I was like, yes! That is an amazing idea. If you know somebody who needs a casserole, if you know somebody whose husband has an addiction, he needs to go to rehab, he has recently gone, maybe it's something that they dealt with not that long ago, like maybe they're like freshly out of rehab, take them a casserole and take them a book. That would be amazing. I am going to be giving some away on my next round. So I have 250 that I have to sell right now, about 150 left. Actually, not even 100 left. You guys are amazing. And I'm like so glad that this didn't flop, because honestly, I don't know how many more rejections I could take. I don't know. It's okay.
I mean, I just don't think I could take that kind of rejection.
I have about 100 more to sell. And then after that, I'm ordering 250 more. This is the way that this is going to go. On my next group of 250, I'm giving 50 away. So if you have a rehab that you think would like some books and they would like a donation, if you have a event that you're going to and you would like to give some books away at the event, or maybe you just want to give some to your Celebrate Recovery group, or maybe you work in addiction ministry and you would like to give some away to some people, please send me a message. I definitely am going to give 10 to a certain group that I'm already like thinking of. It's already in my head, but the other 40 are unclaimed. On the next group of 250 that I order, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to give 50 away. Just this first time, I need enough to so I can buy the next round of books, you know? I really want to do this old school. I want to go old school. I'm so tired of social media. Like, yeah, we can do the social media thing, but I'm so tired of it. Plus, it just feels more like my personality, you know? I want to like put my combat boots on and like go put stickers up on the backs of doors of bars. That's what I really want to do. If you work in a bar, you let me know. I'm going to send you free stickers, okay? I promise. Stick them on the back of the door, please. It's just going to be the message. No one brings you casserole when your husband goes to rehab. Buy it on Amazon, right? And yeah, sorry, I'm ranting. I'm just going on and on and on now with my white ghosty face. It's the sun from my, look at that. How about we just speak like this from now on? I've got some news coming out on my blog, by the way. I actually wrote a blog post. Can you believe it? Like after 2 years, I finally wrote a blog post. What? I'm not pregnant, by the way. Praise the Lord. Knock on wood. because we don't want any of that happening right now. That's the last thing I need, honestly. I was watching this thing. This is like totally unrelated. I'm working on languages. I'm studying so much. Binder 4. Yeah, I did. It's like I'm going to school, but I'm not going to school. I just decided to do it all by myself. Oh, maybe I can put that up for the light. I'm learning Hebrew, but at the same time, I'm still learning French because I just like French and it's really not all that good. So don't start to like parle avec moi. Still pretty crappy. I can read French. Okay. You know, that's about where we're at. I'm on this really cool app called Chatterbug. It's a great way to learn a language. They just don't have that many languages on there. Basically, you listen to a video, you're going to answer questions while you're watching the video, and it's conversational. And you can learn about things that you're actually interested in, food or fashion or history or whatever. So I was watching this Chatterbug, and this woman is telling about her morning routine.
Good morning. Good morning.
Writes in her journal, and then she meditates, and then she exercises, and then she has a shower, and then she does her hair, and she brushes her teeth, and then she has her petit déjeuner. The first thing that she asked was, do you have a morning routine? And I said, yes, I have a morning routine. And then she told me her morning routine. I got thinking like, geez, what's my morning routine? Here's my routine. I get up in the morning, barely, dead, as late as humanly possible. I push it as long as I can. I take my very slow butt downstairs after getting a sweatshirt and slippers and or socks because I'm always freezing in the morning, which is part of why I don't want to get out of bed. Go downstairs and I make coffee because my body feels like a log of bricks and I'm exhausted. And I have one coffee on the couch. Hopefully I have enough time to just have the coffee before I have to speak to anybody. This is actually my routine, I'm not gonna lie. By the time that I'm on the second coffee, I'm like ready to like move around and whatever. I like get so the kids some breakfast because they should be up by now. That's basically it. Maybe I will make them their lunch if we didn't make it the night before, but I'm always mad when I gotta make it in the morning. Sometimes my husband makes it, that's nice. I rush everybody out of the door so that they can go to school, and then I go back to the sofa for my second coffee. I will eat breakfast, and then I go upstairs and I get dressed and I do my hair and my makeup because I shower at nighttime. I think the people that shower in the morning just have good hair. I think that's the only way that you can do it. If I don't shower at nighttime, I will never make it anywhere in the morning. My point is, after I listened to this girl's routine and I thought about my routine, I was like, wow, I gotta get my crap together. I really do. I feel like morning people just like get more done. That's what I'm working on right now. I'm trying to get my crap together so that I can be a morning person who exercises and writes in a journal and meditates. Okay, that's a tall order for the morning for me. Watch for my announcement on Monday. I'll post it Monday, okay? Watch for the announcement on Monday on the blog. It's a biggie. And that's my alarm. It's time for me to go. Thank you to everybody who bought a book already. I love you. You're amazing. I don't know where you came from, and I don't know how this happened, and I just so appreciate you. Thank you. I will see you next time. I'm a little bit nervous about what downstairs looks like. I gotta stop talking. Bye.